Okay, see, basically today, what I will discuss is overall geography syllabus quickly, and then which books you have to definitely buy, and which books you can just refer to. Refer to means in order to buy those books, it will be there in the institute, you can just refer one or two chapters from the book. Okay? Then I'll tell you, if we have to finish entire optional within 3 months, what is the plan I will follow and what is the plan you have to follow? Whatever you have to follow, both are important. Okay? Then generally, from March 1st week, you may have to completely stop everything and prepare only for prelims. For those who are attending prelims for the first time, you have to spend entire March, April, May, all 3 months for prelims. But for the second time, you can start even April also. Prelims you can start April also. Okay? So generally, optional, geography optional, preparation should go hand in hand with the answer writing practice. You cannot think that first 3 months I will prepare completely and after the prelims I will start writing answer. It will not help, because only when you write the answers you will understand how much you have to read. For example, let us say landform development is there, and landform development, you know, lot of books are out of material. As you keep on reading the landform development, you will be collecting so many points. But when you write the answer, you will realize that only few points are enough. Even if you collect lot of points, you cannot use them in the exam. Because the exam, you have to write limited answers, no? Limited space. So only when you write answers, you will realize the importance of reading limited sources, limited material. And even your preparation will be directed in the direction of answer writing. Without writing answers, generally if you are reading, your reading will not be directed towards mains. Generally, you read. Generally, you will try to learn all the facts, by heart, all the issues which are not required for answer writing. Understand? Hence, you have to write answers and read both panel. Now, let us quickly go through geography optional. See, geography optional was very high scoring till 2011-12. After that, for 2 or 3 years, the scores were pretty less. Students were unable to score even 250 out of 500. It became difficult to get 250. But again, from 2016, they started scoring very good marks. For example, in 2017, one guy got 320 marks. He got paper 166 or 162. In that year, many people got around 300. And 2017 also, highest mark is around 168 and 165. 2017 also. So again, people started getting good marks. So now crossing 300 is again normal in the geography option. But between 2012 to 2014 was difficult. Around 3 to 4 years, it was very difficult to score good marks in geography option. So that was the time when people started moving away from geography option. But now again, people start taking geography option. If you observe how to score in geography, generally, see, geography paper 1, geography paper 1, is mostly theory. I mean, you have to learn some concepts from the books. Strictly you have to write in the examination geomorphology, how are mountains built, how are winds flowing, the oceans and the ocean water topography. You have to by heart. Some things have to be by hearted, some things have to be understood, some facts will be there. But geography paper 2 is completely general studies. Means present agriculture in India, present industries in India, migration pattern in India, general studies. I will show papers also. Now we will quickly go through question papers of last 2 years also in this session, so that we understand the pattern of the examination recently and how to prepare for it. Okay? Now, first I will go through geography paper 2 syllabus. Instead of paper 1, first let us go to paper 2 and then see the previous question papers. Okay? Each 250 marks now. Paper 1 250, paper 250. See paper 2 from here. Paper 2. Paper 2 is only Indian geography. Geography India. Paper 1 is world geography. Okay? Come Indian geography. See the first part. Physical setting. Basically, India. The countries around the India. India with neighboring countries. Means the, you know, the boundary shaped by Myanmar, Bangladesh, Nepal, and then what is type of boundary, you know, And even sometimes they ask you relations. For example, in one of the geography paper 2 questions in 2014, I don't remember, the question was, discuss the border problem between India and China. At the time, you have to draw the India map, show the China is bordering India in which states. For example, in the northeastern places, Arunachal Pradesh, Tawang area, what is the border problem? And then Kashmir, Ladakh, what is the border problem? It's current affairs basically. See, at that time, the border issue of India and China was highlighted in the newspapers. So from the newspaper also, you write a lot of points. It's like general international relations. But in general studies, your answer will be mostly McMahon line, you know, the line of actual control, discuss those things. In geography, you'll draw the border, mention the length of the border. Means you write the same answer, but in a geographical way. So here, current affairs matters a lot, current affairs. For example, problem between India and Pakistan. You have to say, the border along the Punjab, border along the Kashmir, border along the Rajasthan, around the Gujarat, circuit line, discuss all those things, okay? Then for example, structure and relief, drainage system and watershed. Basically in India basically the physiographic setting, the Deccan Plateau, Himalayas, hills, you know, other mountains, plains in India. And drainage system is rivers, the rivers in India, what are the various rivers, tributaries. Generally, the main questions in the rivers are very limited. They cannot ask you questions like, what are the various rivers, tell various tributaries, they cannot ask like this. The questions may be, for example, they'll ask you for the drainage pattern, rectangular drainage pattern. You have to discuss where it is formed, how it is formed. Or you know, trellis drainage pattern, some patterns are there. You have to remember some patterns. Each river of India will have one pattern. You will learn those patterns, okay? Then, see, physiographic regions. Same thing, plateaus, the physiography of India, the islands, plains, this is. The mechanism of Indian monsoon. Indian monsoon questions are quite common in the mains about monsoon. They ask about the effect of monsoon on Indian economy, on agriculture, okay? And the effect of El Nino on Indian monsoon, effect of Indian Ocean dipole movement on Indian monsoon. Again, everything comes in newspapers. Of course, you will study in the books, in the class, but newspapers also cover those things. Similarly, rainfall pattern in India, cyclones in India. India has tropical cyclones. Tropical means coming from the Arabian Sea, Bay of Bengal, cyclones come from tropical cyclones. But India also has temperate cyclone. Actually, western disturbance means temperate cyclones coming to India from Mediterranean Sea. It happens only in winter season. It comes to only some parts of India, the western part of Punjab, Haryana, that area. Okay, then floods. See, floods and droughts, mostly current affairs only. Mostly what you learn from newspapers, you can write floods and droughts. Common flood occurring regions in India. What are the problems during the floods? How do you control the floods? What are the different measures you take in the flood area, flood prone area? General common points. Whatever points you learn from disaster management class, you can use it there. Floods, droughts. Climatic regions means, In India, different climates are there. Kashmir has one kind of climate. Maharashtra has one kind of climate. Kerala, Karnataka has one kind of climate. Andaman has one kind of climate. Different climates will study. Climate means essentially precipitation, means rainfall, the temperature, and the winds, the pressure belts, these things only, climate, okay? Then, natural vegetation means types of forests in India. Natural vegetation means forest. Each state has different types of forests. In those forests, what are the different types of forest products you will get there, okay? Different types of trees, flora, fauna, in different forests like this. Even this also they are asking current affairs questions. What are the threats to the Indian forest because of alien species? Sometimes they ask questions like, discuss the various acts and laws passed by the government of India to conserve the forest and how effective are they? General question. Which you learn in environment of general studies or current affairs. Questions are just like that, okay? Simple, then soil types, different soils in India, distribution in India, okay? Then resources, land resources, fertile land, infertile land, barren land of India, forest land, okay? Surface and groundwater, surface water, lake water, river water, groundwater, groundwater means we can ask pollution. Discuss the groundwater pollution in Assam. In Assam, maybe arsenic pollution, you know, in Adilabad, fluoride groundwater pollution. In Punjab and Haryana, groundwater is produced by nitrogen pollution. Like it will study aquifers, okay? Then energy. Energy means energy fossil fuels, solar energy, wind energy. In India, which energy are you using mostly? Even the ask government schemes and acts also. Though this is geography optional, paper 2 is current affairs, I can tell you. Mostly general studies. Paper 2, a person who did not prepare geography option also can write paper directly. But geography option students, what you will do is, while writing that answer, you will add the geographical dimension. Geographical perspective, like that's all. But general answer is general answer only. Okay? Minerals, different minerals, iron, bauxite, different minerals in India. Biotic and marine resources. Means fish resources or coral reefs. Different resources found in the oceans and marine. Biotic resources means life resources. Abiotic means minerals. Biotic means, for example, flora, different plants, the resources you get from the plants and trees and from the animals. It's called bio resources. Forest and wildlife is a condition of land vegetation. First you study the forest. Based on the forest, you study what is the wildlife resources found in those forests, okay? And the conservation. Conservation again, we will talk about the international wildlife conservation, wetland conservation, coral reef conservation, international agreements present on the conservation. It's a very general thing, okay? Then energy crisis. Energy crisis is basically the India is most dependent upon the fossil fuels. So we have energy crisis, okay? Agriculture. 90% is general, what you study in general studies, 10% is geography. For example, irrigation problems in agriculture, micro-irrigation, macro-irrigation, you know, canal irrigation, and the problem with the seeds, fertilizers, power. Generally, many state governments give power subsidies. Example, Punjab, Haryana, they give power subsidies so that you can use the groundwater for irrigation, groundwater, okay? Then institutional factors. Institutional factors means, for example, government acts or policies on the agriculture. For example, institution means anything related to the government. Infrastructure institution, both are possible. For example, road, cold storages, or market facilities provided to the farmers, anything institutional, okay? Land holdings. Land holdings means basically, these days you observe, land fragmentation happening, fragmentation. My grandfather has 100 acres. My grandfather's 10 sons. Each son gets 10 acres. Again, each son has 10 sons. So each son gets one acre. Next 10 sons means 0.1 acre. Like that, land fragmentation. Then land consolidation, how to consolidate the land, okay? Land holdings actually after independence, land holdings are limited for the Jamindars. Land ceiling act was there, land ceiling, limitation of kept. Discuss all those things, okay? Land tenure, land reforms. Land reforms means everything. Computerization of land records, abolition of Jamindari, Jotwari, you know. Then cropping pattern. Cropping pattern means in Western India, what are the various crops? Do they sow three crops per season or only one crop per season? Do they go for monocropping? Rice, always rice, or one time rice, their pulses, cropping pattern. Okay? Agricultural productivity. Productivity is in the limited area, how much you can produce. It depends upon application of fertilizers, using technology, farmers' awareness, literacy rate, government support, everything. Okay? Agriculture intensity. Crop combination. Crop combination means what are the different crops you are combining in a land? In order to combine at the same time, for example, see, mixed farming, rotational farming, all this come in the crop combination. Land capability means, see, entire land here does not have the same capability. You know, some areas highly fertile. You can put, there multi-cropping is possible. They have good irrigation, good groundwater is there. Capability is more. For example, less capability. See, less capable soil, you grow inferior crops, like millets. In high fertile, you grow rice. So basically, land capability classification is there. USA, in USA, entire country they classify the land, high fertile, least fertile, like that. Based on the capability, they will decide which crop they have to grow. In India, farmers do not know. Whatever land, they will grow every crop. And they will fail agriculture, that's the problem, okay? Then agroforestry. Agroforestry means growing trees in the agricultural land. Social forestry, growing trees in the community land, panchayat land. What are the benefits, problems, we'll discuss. Actually, this is environment, okay? Green revolution, a large term. Green revolution, white revolution, you know, pink revolution, rainbow revolution, everything, golden revolution. Means focusing on specific crops, and green revolution is mostly food grains. White revolution means milk production, like that. We'll discuss all those things. okay, then the impact of the green revolution on the socio-economic conditions, how will change the social status of women and men in different states, okay, how will change the economic conditions of different states, different farmers, ecological implication, how green revolution led to degradation of soil, excess use of fertilizers, too much of irrigation, which is degrading the soil, we learn all those things, okay. Significance of dry farming means places where water is less available, less irrigation is there, less rainfall is there. In those places, what kind of crops will grow? How can you, with little water, how can you grow crops? Sprinkler irrigation, drip irrigation, and growing the type of crops which are suitable for less water, like this, okay? Livestock resources. Livestock means piggery, goat, sheep, cattle, poultry, duckery, livestock, okay? And you know, white revolution is dairying, okay? Aquaculture, fishery, prawns, pisciculture. Sericulture means silk, cultivation of silk, silkworms, different types of silkworms grown in India, and how India can become number one silk production, what technology you have to use, okay? What has to be taught to the farmers. For example, Bengaluru Silk Board was a silk board. They do research on the silk production in India. We study about all those things. Apiculture means honey culture. Honey culture actually is diversification of the livelihood for the farmers. Farmers can always be in agriculture, you know. They have all the crops now. They have to go for apiculture, livestock, fisheries, so that they can earn money throughout the year. Okay? Then agricultural regionalization. Regionalization basically, see, actually this year, not in geography optional. In general studies paper 1 question has come. GS chapter 1. How, you know, agro processing units are regionalized in Punjab and Haryana. In each region, certain crop, for example, jute cultivation is only West Bengal. Wheat means Western UP, Punjab, Haryana, like that. Sugar cane is Western Maharashtra, regionalization. Agroclimatic zones. Agroclimatic zones means, actually, Planning Commission of India divide India into several zones based on the climate. Based on the climate and soil, they divide India into several zones. Each zone, which crop is best? In that zone, for example, in Kashmir zone, this crop is best. In the Kerala area, this crop is best. Like that. It's called agro-climatic zones. Okay? Agro-ecological zones. Ecological is based on ecology. Based on the type of soil, based on the fertility, based on the type regional trees available there, you divide them. Okay? Industries. Similar industries. You know, industries, evolution of industries. Location factor. Why steel plant is owned some places? Why jute industry in some places? Why oil refineries are owned in some places? Why software industries are in some places? Location factor. For example, software industry only Bengaluru, Chennai, Hyderabad. Why? For example, cotton textile industries. Why only Gujarat and Tamil Nadu? Otherwise, oil refineries. Why they are in Kanpur and Visakhapatnam Port, Bangalore? Why? Location factors. Okay. Every industry. What location factor? Okay. We'll take each industry. We'll study them in detail. Means that industry needs what? Some industries need more labor. Some need more power supply. Some need more water. Some need better labor, skilled labor. Okay. Some need cheap land. Some need raw material. Some need markets. So each industry needs one specific thing. So based on what it needs, we will locate it. Okay? Then industry houses and complexes, industrial corridors, SEZs, special economic zones are there. Single place, many industries will be there. We study about those things. Special economic zones, CPIRs, you read. Public sector, PSUs. Actually, questions can even come at, what are the problems in the PSUs in India? Why disinvestment is carried on with some PSUs? General studies, current affairs will be there. Okay. Industrial regionalization. Means, for example, in the Gujarat area, textile industries regionalized. In West Bengal, jute manufacturing regionalized. Like that, regionalization. New industrial policies, see, this is pure government. Current affairs. New industrial policies, industrial laws, acts made by the government of India will study. That's why students who read current affairs, no? Paper 2 they will score very good marks. And paper 2 does not need any special preparation. In geography, overall optional. Overall number of hours required is preparation hours is, 100 hours, for example. 100 hours.
In other words, almost 70 hours have come out. Paper 2 just 20 to 30 hours, that's all. Paper 2 will anyhow be carried on with the current affairs, newspapers, current affairs and all.
Multinational MNCs. You know, when MNCs are coming into India, what are the advantages, disadvantages? Liberalization. Liberalization, I told you, one of the classes. Liberalization, privatization, globalization, its impact on the industries, employment, study. SCJs, those. Tourism, including ecotourism. Tourism is a service industry, service. So, tourism also is a good revenue generator for India. India has medical tourism, adventurous tourism. Medical tourism means people coming to India for treatments. Example, Chennai Hospital is famous for kidney transplantation, heart transplantation, they come to cancer treatment, they come to Chennai. Adventure tourism is going to Himalayas, adventure tourism. Cultural tourism, coming to Taj Mahal, coming to temples, cultural tourism. Rural tourism, coming to villages and all. Forest tourism, they come to forest to see the wildlife. Okay? Like that, tourism. Ecotourism specifically, tourism which is ecologically friendly. Ecotourism is, they come to see the forest, wildlife, natural resources, whatever, without affecting the environment. That means they will not pollute the area where they come to, like that, okay? Then transport, communication, trade. Actually, for this, no, NCERT textbook is enough, most. The conceptual part from NCERT textbook is enough. And current affairs part, newspapers is enough. No need to read anything more for this one, okay? Transport means road transport, railway transport. Questions will be like, what are the hindrances to the public-private partnership in the road? Then railway. Does privatization of railway helps? Or how are roadways competing with railways? In India, most of the transportation happens by road, not railway. What are the reasons? They'll ask. What are the reasons? Okay? Then waterway. Why inland waterways is not developed? In India, inland waterways is not very well used. For example, European countries, rivers are very well used for transportation, navigation, goods transport, everything. India uses very less. Why? Okay? Airway, pipeline. Pipeline means for supply of water, oil, gas, pipeline. This is all those things. Complement those regions. In regional development, how do they help? How does the transport help regional development? For example, you know, recently government has planned to Udaan scheme. Government planned to build the airports in the second grade two cities. Previous airports were in top cities. For example, Calcutta, Bengaluru, Chennai. But now they're coming to Grade 2 cities also. Nalgonda, na? Okay, yeah. Grade 2 cities. So how it helps the development? Okay? Actually, good roads, even rural roads, for example, like a village. In village, if roads are very well developed, farmers can easily produce perishable goods, tomatoes, potatoes, they can produce. Without any damage, they can move it to market. But if a rural area does not have good roads, if they produce tomatoes, perishable goods, then they take it to the trucks, what will happen? Damage will be more. When damage is more, farmers stop producing more. Understand? Like it helps, okay? Then growing importance of ports on national foreign trade. Means the importance of the ports, both public ports, private ports, you know, large ports, small ports, their importance on foreign trade. For example, see here, coastal navigation. There is something called coastal navigation. In India, if you see, in India, for example, if you want to move something from Gujarat to Chennai, or Chennai, instead of using road or railway, you can use the coastal navigation. But we don't use it. Very less coastal navigation. We will discuss the reasons for it. Coastal navigation and all, okay? Then trade balance. Trade balance is an economic concept. Not only geography. Trade balance. China, India is there. India-China, if you see the trade relationship, India will import more from China, export less. For example, let us say between India and China, the trade was $70 billion. In $70 billion, $50 billion is India importing. $20 billion is exporting, which is leading to trade deficit. Yes, current deficit. Trade deficit. And two countries are there. Two countries, import-export should be almost uniform. If import is more, export is less, it's a loss to the country. It's loss to the forex, foreign exchange reserve loss, right?
will study all the balance, trade policy, again, current affairs, international relations, trade policy, then export processing zones. Okay? Export processing zones means, see, the places where you produce, manufacture, whatever, old exports. For example, special economic zones are there, no? In special economic zones, in India, there are some special economic zones. One of the idea of SEZs is that whatever you manufacture there, you have to export it. Export it. If you export, no, you have a lot of forex revenue. India, see, China is an exported economy. China today became a very powerful country because of exports. So India should also export. Okay? Again, these are very general newspaper current affairs things. Okay? Export ports and zones, developments in communication technology, communication, what are the satellite communication, what are the new advancements we are doing, okay? Recent communication satellites we have launched, then information technology, IT industry, what are the advancements, ICT. Sometimes I can even ask about role of information technology in agriculture, role of IT in industries, role of IT in service sector, in governance also they can ask, governance. Though it appears as if it's quality, quality question, governance means quality, no? But it will ask in geography number two, okay? Their impact on economic society, the impact of all these things in society, Indian space program. If you read Indian space program, it's optional, your preparation for General Studies paper 3 is over. In General Studies paper 3, you have environment, economics, international trade, science technology, right? Those things will be over by reading these things anyway. For example, these two will help you in General Studies paper 2. In UPSC mains, General Studies paper 2 has international relations. If you read these two very well, that will be covered. Similarly, for example, this will help in General Studies paper 3, economics. Okay? This also, if you read very well this now, your General Studies paper 3, economics is over, industries. Basically, if you read this very well, your preparation for General Studies mains paper 2, paper 3 will be covered. Directly covered, environment will be covered, science technology will be covered, economics will be covered. General Studies paper 1, direct geography is there. In General Studies paper 1, out of 20 questions, 8 questions geography, you will answer very well. In General Studies paper 2, international relations, if you read this, it will be helpful indirectly. General Studies paper 3, economics, science and technology, environment will be covered in paper 2. So, interlinking is more, interlinking, okay? Then, for example, cultural setting. Again, this is actually General Studies Paper 1, UPSC, Society of India, you know, Society of India, GS1. Society, this is society, racial, different races in India. But you have to go deep. Here, the geography will go deep. You learn different races in India. Different races, names you learn. Linguistic, ethnicity, different ethnicities in India, ethnicities. Different languages, the revolution, okay? Village minorities, tribes in India, tribal areas in India. It will cover your Society of India paper 1. That's why some people, of course, many people who prepare geography optional very well can answer these questions very well in the General Studies. In General Studies 1, 2, 3, 4 is not possible. 1, 2, 3, you can score little more marks because of this one, okay? Then the cultural regions of India. Culturalism means, for example, culture means dance, food habits, dressing habits, right? Cultural region means a region having same dress style, same food habits, a region having same language, religion, cultural regions, okay? Growth, distribution, density, population. Population growth in different states, distribution, density. Why West Bengal has more population density, okay? How to control population in some areas. Demographic attributes, sex ratio. For example, in Punjab, Haryana, sex ratio is very less. There are only 870 females for 1,000 males. Okay? Kerala, good sex ratio. Almost 1,000 females for 1,000 males. Okay? Age structure, literacy rate, general. But literacy rate, different state literacy rate. Questions can be like, questions can be. In the last decade, literacy rate has improved a lot. However, there are certain pockets which could not catch up with the development. Discuss the reasons for it. Prioritizations, also add some government schemes regarding it. It's a GS question, general question, okay? Then dependency ratio. Dependency ratio means number of old people per young people. See, dependence means who? Children and old people. some people add person disabilities also, but if you can provide good jobs for the disabled people, they will not become dependents. But children and old people are generally dependents. Dependency ratio of Japan is very high. In Japan, children are less, but old people are more. It's called aging population, aging. Because of that, Japan is getting into crisis. So we'll talk about those things. Dependency ratio, okay? For example, in India, young people are more young people. They can work, earn a lot of money. That money they can help for their parents, grandparents, old people. In Japan, old people are more. Old people don't work now, sit in the home like this, mostly. Young people have to work, that money has to go to old people, which is a burden for the economy, national economy, right? Because government has to provide a lot of pensions, more pensions than salaries in those countries, that is problem. Salaries will give for work, pension will give for previous work. Okay? So now, what is the dependence ratio? Longevity. Longevity means the lifespan. Lifespan is increasing in India, lifespan is increasing. Okay? The migration. Migration both inter-regional. Inter-regional within South India, within Andhra, everybody coming to Vijayawada from other places, inter-regional. Actually, inter-regional means one region to another region. Intra-regional means within a region. Within region means within South India, what is the migration? Within Andhra, what is the migration? Inter-region means from Jharkhand to Punjab, Bihar to Maharashtra, that thing, okay? International migration. Inter-region means both along the borders, other countries. See, migration can be for job opportunities, for business, or for education, or for asylum. Refugees. Some people come as refugees now, political asylum. Different patterns are there. Okay? So this is all those things. Then the problems associated with migration. Migration is, for example, when more refugees are coming into Assam from Bangladesh, what are the problems? Sometimes for this they'll ask the genocide question. They can ask question about what is it? In Assam, what is the problem?
Mm-hmm.
Huh? No, recently government Supreme Court has ordered.
NRC.
You are reading about NRC? Huh? So that will directly ask. Discuss the NRC. Do you think it should be implemented throughout India or only Assam? So general discussion only. Understand? The problems. Population problems and policies. The population problems. The problem because of population. Okay? Health indicators. Health indicators, everything, morbidity, death ratio, diseases, all the things. Infections. Settlements. Settlements means the pattern of urbanization, construction of houses, the pattern, okay? How houses are built up along the roads, in the plains, in the flood area, how settlements, buildings, okay? So, type settlements, patterns. For example, in Kerala, if you see, linear pattern. Along the road, houses will be there. In some villages, circular pattern. Around a lake, houses will be there, circular pattern. Like this, okay? Rural settlements, the structure, rural settlements, for example, rural areas, caste-based settlement, caste-based. In entire village, one caste will be here. Lower caste will be somewhere away. Caste-based settlements will be there, morphology, okay? Then urban development, everything, road development, infrastructure development, settlements, vertical development, everything, urban development. Cities, morphology of Indian cities. Here, morphology will start from ancient India. In ancient India, see, cities are partly Putra, what is structure of cities. In medieval history, Mughal cities, during the Mughal rule, there are cities now. In those cities, what is the structure of city? In colonial India, for example, in you see Chennai, due to the colonial deal, white people are one place, Indians are one place. Based on the classification of labor, classification of the race, they used to make city. For example, British actually planned a city, planned one area only parks, one area industries, one area residential area, one area schools and hospitals, like they divide, okay? And modern cities, mostly modern cities in India are unplanned cities, unplanned, except Chandigarh and some other cities, most unplanned cities. We study about morphology. Functional classification of Indian cities. We classify cities, for example, some cities are basically tourist cities, some are software cities, some are industrial cities. For example, see Jamshedpur. Industrial city, industry. The main function is industries. Okay? For example, take Agra. Agra is a tourism city, the main tourism city. Okay? Bangalore, IT city, IT hub. But Bangalore is an IT city. Administration also, capital both. So based on the function of the city, you will classify cities. Study those, okay? Conurbations and metropolitan. Conurbation means two urban areas coming together. Secunderabad, Hyderabad. Guntur, Vijayawada. Conurbation. okay? Then metropolitan regions, metropolitan actually expanding large cities, okay? Urban sprawl. Sprawl means unplanned development. Take Chennai. Initially, Chennai is only this one Chennai. But now Chennai is increasing. Unplanned, increasing sprawl. Okay? Slums and problems. Slums will be there. Because as city is expanding unplanned, the poorest people of city, poorest people who cannot afford the land, buy the land, they stay in kind of shacks, slum areas. Okay? Town planning, how should you plan that city? Problems, urbanization, remedies. Because urbanization, many problems coming. Pollution problem, land problem, congestion problem, water problem. Problems coming now. This is all the problems. This one is important. This one actually, you will not have, as I told you, you will not have good books for this one. For these previous things, books will be there. For these kind of things, I will give my notes. For regional planning, I have my notes of each region, what is the plan you have for tribal region, hill region. I told you in the morning also, drought region, flood region, in West Bengal, what is the plan, Jharkhand, what is the plan. Everything is segregated, prepare notes. And then, Note also, you can add points from newspapers. When you get new points in newspaper, you can add them. Jharkhand development, West Bengal development, Annamalai development. Okay? Experience of regional planning. Regional planning, from 1947, trying it now. Experiences, 5-year plans. 5-year plans in order to buy out all the year plans. Just me. First 5-year plan, agriculture, and industries. Just touch the main thing. In order to buy out everything. And I think they will not ask now because. No 5-year plans, no? Integrated road development program. Integrated means, see, road development occurs in different sectors. We develop agriculture, cottage industry, rural roads, you know, rural employment, integrate all of them. Together, this is integrated road development. Okay? Panchayat Raj, see, politics. Panchayat Raj, decentralized politics. GS number 2. That's what I told you now. I think I told you already. Geography will have GS2, GS3, everything, GS1, everything. This Panchayat Raj regional planning is completely politics. Okay? Command and development program, watershed management. Command and watershed management is along a river, along the reservoir, along the lake, how do you develop the places? Command area. Okay? Planning for backward area is again number 2. Politics. Backward area planning, development, desert planning, drought area, how to develop, hill areas, what is development model, okay? Tribal area, what development will do, multi-level planning, multi-level means that one only, district level, state level, central level, village level, city level, municipality, panchayat, three-tier system, study all those things, okay? Regional planning and development of island territories, islands, how to develop the islands, so basically this is about regional development. Of course, developing India is one thing. Development each region. Every region requires different plan, unique plan. For example, hills are there. In hills, transportation should be one type. In desert, transportation one type. In hills, agriculture is one type. In deserts, agriculture is another type. You understand? So, depending on which area, level of development, the kind of culture, resources, you have to adopt a developmental plan. Like that, okay? Then finally, not worry, 10 chapters only, okay? See, political aspects, see, completely GS paper 2, interest of boundary of India, see, geopolitics of geographical basis of Indian federalism. Federalism, which paper? Paper 2, polity, federalism. Then state reorganization, which paper? History, paper 1, state reorganization, paper 1, history. Emergence of new states, again, paper 1, history. Regional consciousness and interested issues, paper 2. Interested issues, Tamil Nadu, Karnataka, water issue. Okay, see, generally the border states will have some issues of resources, water, okay, under the Telangana issues, border issues, then international border of India and related issues, same, problem China, all Pakistan, all Nepal, forest boundary, with Myanmar drug mafia, Myanmar, cause what terrorism, terrorism is again intersecurity, this is intersecurity. Inter security, which paper? GS3. GS3. See, it's there. India's only moral affairs. Which paper? GS2. interrelations, geopolitics of South Asia, Indian Ocean Realm, GS2, interrelations. Okay? Complete 10 questions. I'll show you question number also. Okay? Now, contemplations. Contemporary means current affairs, that's all. Contemporary means current affairs. See, ecological issues, environmental hazards, landslides, earthquakes. If you read these things, your preparation for environment, GS is over. Okay? Issue of environment pollution, changes in patterns of land use. Land use patterns means previously used for agriculture, same land now using for, take Andhra Pradesh, Amaravati. Agriculture land, converted into capital. So land use pattern is changing. Principle of environmental impact assessment, EIA. This is directly general service department. Environmental management assessment. So you know, okay? Environmental impact assessment means before you start any project in any area, you have to study the effect of that project on the birds, animals, soil, vegetation, groundwater, study everything. And submit reports called EIA reports. If the report is okay, then there are other projects. However, in India it's not posted. Okay? Then population explosion. There's too much increased population. Example, Northeast India, the North India, some parts, okay, explosion. Food security problem. Okay? You know, food security problem can be solved by controlling population, increasing the productivity of agriculture, and diversification, not depending only on the food crops but also meat, fisheries, etc. You know, degradation, how environment is degraded, spoiled in India. Deforestation problem. Desertification. Desertification means conversion of more and more land. Desertification means not becoming desert. Desertification means one area is there. In that area, if groundwater is reducing, trees are reducing, soil fertility reducing. Desertification. Desertification. Okay? Agrarian unrest means the farmers, the unrest in them, the problems of the farmers. Industrial unrest means the problems of the industries, employees, these things. Regional disparities in economic development. Jharkhand, not developed. Telangana, highly developed. Rajasthan, not developed. Gujarat, highly developed. Regional disparities. Why some regions are developed economically, why not developed? Reasons. Discuss reasons, okay? Concept of sustainable growth and development. Sustainable growth again, GS paper 3. Internal awareness paper 3, linkage of rivers, interlink of rivers, problems and the say this question they will repeat several times in geography, you know. Interlinking of rivers. What are the challenges and what are the advantages? Give solutions for problems. Globalization economy, which one? GS3. This is how GS paper, this is what the geography paper 2, see. Ganesh paper 2? Do you want to see GS paper 2, geography paper 2 questions you want to see? I have all the syllabus now. Let us see the questions. Let us see questions of GS paper 2. Which year you want to see? This year, last year? See, first question is map pointing. 20 mark map pointing. Without reading also, generally you can keep map pointing. Out of 10 map points, 5 are easy. Remaining 5, if you prepare geography very well, you can keep. Otherwise, you'll lose. Okay? Mostly comes in current affairs. This has come in current affairs of that year. Okay? Means in the newspapers, whatever comes in the newspapers, no, they'll ask. They'll give map, you have to mark the points. Now read the questions. Do you think you need to prepare these questions? Examine the causes for groundwater depletion. It's the general sense, easily can write. Agriculture, overuse of irrigation, industries not using fresh water, domestically there's no water, winter water pricing, so exploitation of water, pollution of water, pollution of groundwater. General answer only. Nothing geography in this one. Why is Indian monsoon erratic in nature? Indian monsoon, why it is not normal, erratic? Because of, well, you know, Indian Ocean dipole movement. What is that?
Dipole movement.
General question. Explain significantly. Oh, what is one here? Map pointing, okay. Explain significant dry farming in drought prone areas. In drought prone areas, there is no water, no. Hence, you have to go for dry farming. Dry farming means you have to sprinkle irrigation, drip irrigation. You have to grow pulses, millets, but not rice. General question. Correlate the, this is first part. First four questions are? Compulsory questions. Compulsory. No choice. From now onwards, you have a choice. For example, you have second question, third question, fourth question, fifth question, right? Out of these, you can choose any. See, overall, basically, in overall exam, we have 5 questions. 5. In the 5 questions, first and fifth question must you have right. First and fifth you have right, must. Okay.
There are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7,
8 questions, okay? First one must, fifth one must. Other than that, you have to write any 3 questions, 3. You can write 2 here, 1 here, whatever. Choice will be there. Very good choice will be there. An option. General studies, no choice, okay? Now, so second thing, four and five might choose are those questions. Diet from syllabus. Syllabus is there now. Syllabus is all these questions. Additionally, you want to do. If in the syllabus, if every part of syllabus you make notes, just take the syllabus of UPSC means, geography optional. Every part of the syllabus you make a notes. I will also, while dealing geography optional, though I deal generally all topics, individually also, each syllabus topic I will show you and I will discuss about the topic. But in the initial, I will cover entire syllabus. Later, I will go through each topic also. Okay? So, direct on the topic they are given, as is. For example, we have a lot of questions. Do you think this is geography? This is the question. Is this economics or geography?
Economics.
Economics. That's why geography paper 2 can be answered by anybody. If you are preparing for UPSC mains general studies, paper 2 is over. No separate preparation. No. That's why geography paper 2, see, out of 250 marks, if you write generally, you can get 100 to 120 you can get. If you prepare for paper 2, take the syllabus, each topic, prepare slightly, you will get 150. But to get 150, in your answers, you have to use geographical dimension, geographical perspective at right. If you write like general answers, you get 120 only, 120. To get 150 at right, but people are getting 165, I told you now, 165, 170 also you can get easily. By what? Drawing more diagrams, more flowcharts, more maps, writing more points, correlating. That, my friends, is called answer writing skill. And remember, as you know already, people who are listening to my classes, you know that while discussing the geography optional, in the class itself, I will tell you answer writing skill for every topic. This topic, what diagrams you have to draw, how you have to write the answer, what you have to correlate, what are the base dimensions. Because my dealing of the option entirely is answer writing format. Because option is only for writing answers, not for objective questions, not for understanding lot of concepts and by heart, in fact, not required. You should write good answers, that's all. Okay? This is actually a general studies question. MNC's role in economic development. Okay? Easily you can write answers, very easily. Then what is this? This is also a normal economics question only. Economics question. Overall port in India. How watershed management has become true by the world board? If you manage the water very well, how can you eliminate the poverty? Okay? Then, environment question. Normal question. What are the fertilizers, pesticides, insecticides? What are the chemicals used in that one? You got chemicals, what problem? Get lung problem, heart problem, kidney problem, urology problem, which problem? Give some examples. In Kerala, what are the pesticide used? In Punjab, what pesticide used? What are the fertilizers? Because current affairs, diseases. Environmental book is there now. In that book, if you remove the diseases, you can write it down. Directly, direct question. Exam audience case one. See. This is paper 3. Science and technology. Direct question. Examining ongoing space for India, implications national security. Ongoing space programs. For example, manned mission, space station, you know, navigation, navic, and how it helps in the security. Security of India, border security, water security, food security of India. Okay? Security in the future. We discuss those things. So these are very general questions. That is why if I keep examination even right now, you can ask about it. That's a geography optional. The main reason why geography optional is easy is because of paper 2. But the main reason is difficult is because of paper 1. Okay? Paper 1 you have to work. Okay? Then discuss their rainfall pattern. Where is it? Rainfall pattern. Distribution natural vegetation. Direct question. Generally, draw a map. In that, discuss rainfall pattern based on the, for example, evergreen forest, rainforest, I told you in the class already. In the geography class, evergreen forest, 2 centimeters, 3 centimeters. Then semi-evergreen, 200 centimeters. Dry deciduous, more deciduous forest. Each forest you take, natural vegetation, you take each forest, tell how much rainfall you. That's all. Draw India map, in the map show different forests and rainfall. Direct question, end of the question. NCRT is actually for geography paper 2, you just, is enough if you read NCRTs. But if you want a comprehensive understanding, very good, you read which book? Kullar. Please buy Kullar, Indian Geography by Kullar. K-H-U-L-L-A-R, Kullar. Okay? You have to buy that book first for paper 2. But I know people who did not even open Kullar. Just NCRTs, current affairs, and whatever notes. For example, in my class, I'll give notes now. Entire paper 2, I'll give notes. You read the notes now. Just that notes. NCRT is kind of enough. But if you want additional resource, Kullar is good. And Kullar is enough. Of course, Indian Geography by Masjid Hussain is there. Masjid Hussain you buy any month, either Kullar or Masjid Hussain. I prefer Kullar. Kullar, okay? Just single book, see? Paper to single book, okay? Then, the political aspirants of Himalaya. Political aspirants of Himalaya. Himalaya is border for China, Nepal, you know. Bhutan, India, so political aspect of Himalaya. Explain how it has affected this geostatus, geopolitical consciousness of individualism. This question, as it is, it will be given in the just paper 2 also. Paper 2. How the Himalayan water is affecting the geostrategy? Geostrategy means geologically countering the enemy countries, the neighboring countries, okay? And then geopolitics. Geopolitics means again, see, geostrategy, politics, both are similar, however, slight variation. Geopolitics is, for example, Nepal is there. With Nepal, the politics which follow is a forest, means free movement. With China, we do not follow that point. Strategy is that, the strategy of China, if you observe, China always says that Tawang belongs to China and some parts of there's always a border problem within China. Actually, the strategy of China is continuously you claim more land. So that constantly there are disturbance. You keep on maintaining disturbance till China becomes strong. Once China becomes strong, they can easily say it's ours. India cannot do anything. Right now, India is equally powerful. Okay? Right now, when India is equally powerful, China does not want to settle the issue. China wants to wait till it becomes very powerful. Once it becomes very powerful, it's very easy to settle the issue. India listens to what China says. This is the strategy of China, actually. Okay? Similar, India also has a strategy. Okay? Regional consciousness of Indian federalism. Actually, see, because of Himalayas, the Northeast India, the Himachal Pradesh, Uttarakhand, okay? So, see, Uttarakhand specifically asking for a separate state, do you know why? Because Uttarakhand and UP are together once upon a time. But UP is completely plain, Uttarakhand is hilly. So, the developmental pattern is different. You cannot use same developmental method for plain and hill. That's why Uttarakhand is not developed. That's why they are not separate state. It's also politics. Okay, regional development politics. We will discuss all those issues, both international as well as state federalism. Okay, we will discuss those things. Okay, so regional development of information technology in India. See, this one we will use geography. Second thing, isn't it directly then the syllabus? If you observe geography, most of the questions, what are given syllabus now? Same line they will bring put in the question. That's one. So if syllabus is prepared, just take syllabus each topic, just write small notes on every topic, come to the exam, same things will be there. Direct answers. But I know many people, they read Kulla, they read NCERT, everything, but they don't read syllabus. Geography syllabus is a paper 2. Syllabus, each point, you take the point, write small notes. You make your own notes. So there will be content, okay, end the syllabus and finish, contents. And questions come directly, see, this is a question. You know syllabus, this is directly, okay? Then, and once you prepare notes, you have to show it to me. I'll make changes in the notes. Everyone in the class have to prepare whatever topic I'm dealing after going to the home. Home is not in that day. Any of the class is not daily class, weekly class. No. Within that week, whatever finish it, you have to make short notes. Mix current affairs and show it to me. I'll add some more current affairs, we'll finalize it. Once finalized, keep on revising. Optional strategies, revise and write. Notes, revise, write. Anybody who follows these three will definitely get excellent marks. Notes, revise, Anybody who follows strategy definitely will get excellent marks in optional. Make notes. Not all topics. Main topics which are not there in the book title, make notes. Topic wise notes. Revise that note 5 times. Keep on revising the notes. Any time last question, you tell the answer. If you revise notes many times, no? What like in your brain, everything will be linked up, mixed up. So that if any question is asked, you can get an answer from different sources, you can get an answer. Finally, right. You have at least 700 answers you have read before going for mains examination. At least 700 answers you have read. Without that, you cannot get most. Anybody who writes around answers in the exam, almost same will come. Okay? So, anybody who follows the strategy, particularly in geography, definitely you will get more than 280. Go, now you want to get 300? Right? 1000 answers. Okay? Get them evaluated. Whatever changes, I tell you. So, whatever, when I change current numbers, no? When I come to numbers, it will change, right? Those changes, you have to make a note somewhere. And it implement all changes. Finally, at one point of time, your answer, I should not be able to tell any change. Perfect answers. Don't try to me immediately. Slowly, perfect answers. A perfect answer, you can even get 350 marks. 350. Okay? Now, what is this? Direct question. Yes, sir. Other standards. Workforce availability in India. Employment. Age structure. Age group of. Actually, workforce means age to 18 years to 60 years, 58 years. It's workforce. They work now. Below that, after that, you cannot work now. So that structure, how many are there? Which state has more workforce? Are they employed, unemployed? All those things, okay? What is it? Write about Narmada, Tapti, the features. They are Rift Valley, where they are originating, what kind of soil they are growing in, just the river, this one. How is the Vaila Kadarishwar? What is this? Anybody can answer, even 10th student can answer this question. Problems in wildlife conservation. You want to conserve the wildlife, but what are the problems? One is the climate change, one is the loopholes in the government policy, other thing is people don't have awareness. Other things, the aliens which are coming. Maybe you can write many things. Correlate the price of land, vertical growth of cities. Vertical growth means cities growing like this. Yes. Because cities are limited area, no? People are more, no? So you have to build vertical growth. Blow the slums. Why slums are going? Okay? In large areas of India. This is a general question. General question. Okay? You read Bombay, Chennai, Calcutta, slums, why the slums are going. Mostly slums are the people who come to city in search of jobs. The people from surrounding villages now, they come to city, they don't have any job. Search for construction jobs, some, you know, daily wage labor. This is a repeated question in UPSC. Footloose industry means the industry foot is loose. So for example, see, some industries were established at a place where raw material is there. Some industry has a place where water is there. Some industry has to be anywhere you can establish. There is no location. Anywhere you can keep the industry. That is called foot is loose. They can go anywhere. Okay? Now, what is important? The importance is that these are industries which can develop India. Because you establish them anywhere. No particular place, no. Then you are ready to develop backward areas in India. For example, backward regions don't have, let us say, they don't have water resources, don't have natural resources, don't have anything. Lab or nothing. Even in the establishment, I give examples of different industries. Some give examples of 10 industries, tell the places. Okay? Now, expert also glacial lake outburst flood in India. Actually, glacial lake outburst flood has come in newspaper not that year, before 2 years. See, glacial lake outburst flood means sudden melting of glacier. Okay? Because of which some lakes are fed by the glaciers. Glaciers come, they create lake. The water comes from the glaciers. Because of outburst of the glacier, sudden melting of glacier, more water comes out of the lake, which floods the surrounding places. Read about that one. Okay. Interbasin, linkages. River are more feasible than the ocean. Intrabasin linkages, river linkages only. Internal linkages of rivers are more feasible than the ocean. They are saying it's more feasible. More feasible, okay? So you can talk about Krishna Godavari basin linkage, okay? Then the Ken Betwa linkage, what happening in India, and tell why only intra basin linkage is more feasible. Then linking the rivers of different basins. Only rivers of same basin linking is feasible. But linking of different basins is not feasible. You discuss those ideas. Actually, this is right from syllabus. Linkage of rivers is right from syllabus. So when you prepare notes for linking rivers now, we talk about all these things. Fortunately, right now we all these things. Okay?
The format is an account of emerging conversations in there.
Conversation means urban areas combined together. Why it is increasing in India? Why it is increasing? Because expansion, population, expansion, Guntur this much, Vijayawada this much, expand, they will finally come in. Okay. It was in that. I could remember about green tourism. First of all, we have to environment question. Green tourism means basically tourism that is not polluting. Tourism that is conserving the wildlife. Sometimes, you know, tourism helps in conservation. For example, tourists are not coming, no? Poachers will come, they will come take away the animals, they will come cut the trees and go. But tourists are there always, nobody can rob the trees or resources, wildlife. Understand? L is the mountain environment. Particularly mountain areas, tourism is very important. Ecological environment field tourism. Because in mountain areas, this observation is less, monitoring is less, mountain areas. People will come and take away what? If it is tiger, if it is elephant, take away the tusk. If it is one-horn rhino, take away the horn. Whatever they will take away, whatever they are finding. Okay? To stop that, you have to analyze the green tourism. Right? Analyze the role of interested migration and disparity. See, for example, you can say from green revolution. In green revolution time, people from Bihar, UP used to come and work in Punjab, Haryana. Interested migration. Because of that, what happened? Punjab, Haryana has developed. UBRS, not undeveloped. When the cream of one state or village goes to other place, that place will develop. This will not develop. Understand? This is migration, migration. Jharkhand is there. From Jharkhand, Orissa, many people come to work in Chennai, Tamil Nadu and Telangana. That is why this is developing. If those young people stay there only, if they do entrepreneurship there only, those will develop. No. That's why government is trying for skill development. Young people, so that in their state they can do entrepreneurship, self-employment, and they can develop. Okay. Then what is this? Yeah, this is like what I have produced North India. This is some news. This is current affairs news. North India because stubble burning. Okay. Because of three crops in a year, and because of the type of climate in North India, dry climate for a long time. Yeah, landlocked. Very good. Landlocked. South India is mostly sea is there. Pollution disappears. North India is no place. Neither will discuss reasons for pollution of the cities. And we'll discuss about recently in the globally polluted cities.
Delhi top.
Among top 10, how many are India?
Five.
I think eight. Out of top 10, eight cities are India. In the eight, how many northern cities are there? All eight. Okay, so current affairs. Newspaper, they gave very clearly why north cities are highly polluting. Direct article newspaper, not single newspaper. This came almost 20 times in newspaper that year. 20 times. You will not miss it. Okay. Then, regional balance is how to remove. How to remove balance means each region you have developed differently. Jharkhand developed agriculture, mining. In Orissa, you developed the food processing or marine resources. Each state developed one way. All states can develop the same way. For example, if it is Himalayan states, there are tourism. Tourism will bring a lot of money. Like this, okay? Later it will be there. This is the last question. Okay. India is emerging as a global power in relation to Indian Ocean. This is a direct question from GS2. Same question will be asked in GS2 also in relations. Okay? Himalayas, water hazards, landslides, floods, road bus, all these things, okay? Later you can write interest rates. This is again which is followed. Later you can write all answers. So did you understand what is geography paper 2? Now how many of you think that geography paper 2 is difficult to study? Do you ever think like it? If you're not thinking, I'll go to paper 1. Paper 1 you think. Okay? But paper 1 I tell you, paper 1 is for people who can understand the concepts. And let me tell you, I will spend most of my time, coaching time, that one more. Paper 1, every concept, I will spend enough time, actually detail. But if you do not understand any concept, on the same day after the class, you have to meet me, finish the concept. Okay? Don't wait next week, because if in this week, if you start the Sunday, I explain some concepts, you have to finish them by next Saturday. And again, when you come next Saturday, before starting the class, I will have an examination. I told you, no. 20 minutes exam will be there. 20 minutes exam, every class, every 6 hours class, first student exam only. So, start the Sunday, finish the class. Next week, you have to prepare everything. No, what's everything, everything. Come next Saturday, you have to come, should ready. Come ready. Then I will produce exam, get the exam, then the class. So, in these 3 months, already finish optional. Complete preparation will be there. And answer, should I correct? You show me, I will correct. Don't show me, I will not correct. Okay? So, you know, I cannot ask, you will show me, I cannot ask. You're interested, you show me. But exam, you have to finish. Exam, you have different rate. Okay? So, you have enough time. And in course of time, if I feel that if we are going okay, we are adapted to the class, understanding everything, reading properly, I will increase the speed of classes. Speed means, for example, instead of Sunday, I will plan Monday, Tuesday, Thursday, Friday. If it is on weekdays, 2 to 5 classes will be there, 2 to 5, weekdays. If it is Saturday, 2 to 5, Sunday,
8 to 1.
Either 8 to 1 or 2 to 7.
Yes.
It depends upon the situation. Okay? If you are ready for 8 to 1, come 8 to 1. Or 2 to 7. Whatever, it's 5 hours class. But if you are uncomfortable with those classes, then weekday classes. Tell me how many of you are comfortable with Saturday 2 to 5, Sunday 8 to 1. That one. Other is Monday, Wednesday, Friday 2 to 5, 2 to 5. Which one do you want?
Second option.
How many of you? See, first option is. The first option is
weekend full weekdays and different
Saturday 2 to 5, Sunday 8 to 1. How many hours?
3 and
8. 8 hours.
5.
Other thing is Monday,
Wednesday,
Friday 2 to 5, 2 to 5, 2 to 5.
9 hours.
But here you have to come for 3 times. Then you have to come only 2 times. That word is there. That word is there. Okay? But here, water teacher Monday, Tuesday will finish it. Water doing Wednesday, Thursday will finish it. You have only 1 day to finish. Here, water teach, you have 5 days to finish. 5 days will be there to finish. So you have to understand both the things and think the word. And then you just take some time, think, and let me know by tomorrow. Today evening. Maybe by 8 o'clock. Based on current time. Because. But if you're ready for both. Just tell me what you are most comfortable with, I will go with those classes. And now I have to start this one. I have to start one job. Paper one job. So start or not break. No break, right? Jog. How many of you feel that I'm telling very fast? Orientation class now, that's why I tell like this. And finish under syllabus in one class. Next class, we will take each part and we will go slowly. You're not understanding now, actually. I'm going very fast, right? Understand you, Kumar? Yeah, right? Understand me? Now let's go to paper 1. Paper 1 has 2 parts. Paper 1 has 2 parts. First part is mostly physical geography, has oceanography, studying the oceans, climatology, studying the air, winds, climate, you know, all these things. Then geomorphology, studying of the formation of lakes, rivers, landforms, mountains. It's mostly that imagine how our mountains form, how our rivers form, how our winds flowing, how our oceans. I spend most of my time in this one. Because this is a place where most students have to become very strong. If you become strong in this physical geography, you know, you will become extremely confident. The students who are very confident in geography optional are those people who spend more time on physical geography. Physical geography. Geomorphology. For example, geomorphology has... See. Now I will not explain everything. Just see. For example, landforms. Different landforms. River, lakes, mountains. Endogenetic means forces inside the earth. Exogenetic means forces outside the earth. Means wind, river, rainfall, these things. Inside means earthquake, volcano, plate movement, these things, okay?
all evolution of the Earth crust, how Earth crust is formed, different theories will be there, theories. From geomagnetism. Earth is a magnet now. How Earth is a magnet? Those were the physical conditions of Earth's interior. Inside Earth, what different layers? Actually, these are 10th class questions. 10th class. Inside Earth, different layers, how they are formed, how should it be, okay? Then, you know, geosyncline. Geosyncline means actually long, narrow ocean places from which mountains are built. Okay. Continental drift. How continents are moving from the Earth continents. Okay. Isostasy means balance. Balance, for example, mountain is heavy. Ocean may be heavy. Mountain may be light. How is balancing? In the Earth, some places are heavy places, some are light places. Overall, how balance is maintained? It's called isostasy. Plate tectonics. Entire Earth is made up of some plates. Those plates are always moving. It's called tectonics. Recent piece of mountain building. Olden days, they told several theories of how mountains are built. Every scientist will think some method will tell. But recently, what is the view? Recent view means this will be received only. How mountains are built by plate tectonics. How Himalayas are built? Collision between? Indian plate and? Okay. Then volcanicity, how volcanoes are coming, what is the composition of volcanoes, distribution of volcanoes, effects of volcanoes, all those things. Okay. Earthquakes, study about earthquakes, okay? Tsunami, how it is formed, cause of geomorphic cycles and landscape development, this is very important. Here study, daily cycle, peng cycle, how, for example, in a place, slowly it will develop, it will become mountain. Not become mountain, wind and water will remove the mountain. Again, it will become plain. Again, if you come out 10 million years, mountain will be there. Again, come out 1 billion years, plain will be there. Cycle. Earth is a cycle. Aravali mountains are there now. Aravali mountains, once upon a time, are taller than
Himalayas.
Now they are reducing. Now nothing is there. Nothing is there. Now just 2 kilometers height is there. Come out 10 billion years, Aravali will be over. No Aravali. Come out 1 billion years, Himalayas is over. No Himalayas. Cycle. Okay? Then, you know, denudation means that one. Denudation means how erosion. Denudation means removal of matter. Chronology. Channel morphology, erosion surfaces, how erosion occurs in different places. Slope development. Slope development means how slope is developed. How slope is developed. That's actually mountain building. Okay? Applied geomorphology. Applied means whatever you learned in geomorphology, how do you apply it? Apply it in the real time. Environment, development, government policies, how do you apply it? Okay? For example, you study about tsunami, you apply it for saving people. How do you save people during tsunami? Methods to save people. You study about the volcanoes. You study earthquakes. How do you study earthquakes? Based on earthquakes, what are the structures you have to build? Buildings you have to build such a way that will not be destroyed by the earthquake comes. A Japan building will move like this. Again, this time. Indian building will fall like this. Directly. Okay? So, this is applied geomorphology. How do you apply it? How do you apply your learning with geohydrology means study of water. Means groundwater, river water. Economic geology. Economic minerals. Minerals analysis. Environment. Okay? Then climatology. Climatology means For these things, I'll tell you, generally for geomorphology, climatology, oceanography, biogeography, inland geography, all these five, one book is there. What is the book? Savindra Singh. It's a very good book, generally. That book is must. Every geography optional student has to read Savindra Singh. But along with Savindra Singh book, this must book, there are some books which you have to refer, not study, refer. Those books are for ocean, for geomorphology, one book is there. For climatology, one book is there. For oceanography, one book is there. Like that. Okay? I'll tell you what you see. For example, for geomorphology, there's a book by Savindra Singh only. See, actually, physical geography by Savindra Singh, one book is there. In that book, all books will be there. That book is must. Along with that, if you want, you can buy only for geomorphology Savindra Singh. But that book you should not read completely. Just you have to read some 5 to 6 important chapters, that's all. Similarly, climatology, one book is there. D.S. Lal. Again,
you should not read the book completely. Only few topics you are doing. Because anyhow you are reading the physical geography by Savindra Singh. You reading now? Is enough. But it's difference. Few chapters, I will suggest few chapters. Those geomorphology by Savindra Singh. Climatology by?
Yes, sir.
Ocean not required. Not required. Ocean. Now, climatology, see. Climatology. Pressure depends on the world. As discussed in the normal geography, in the world, high pressure belts, low pressure belts, subtropical high belts, wet pressure belts. Then heat budget of the earth, heat budget. How much energy is coming from the sun? In that heat, how much is going out of the earth? Through the ocean currents, through it, how much is going out? Heat budget. Atmosphere circulation, the earth, atmosphere, how winds are going, planetary winds, how they are moving, planetary winds, westerly, easterly, these things. Atmosphere, instability, atmosphere, generally atmosphere, generally the lower portion is very, as we go up, temperature will
decrease.
So if you observe generally, lower part is hot, upper part is cool, so it will be stable generally. Unstable means, what happens is, unstable atmosphere means, you know, torpedoes, air moving, turbidity, air keep on moving, not stable. Unstable. What are the conditions that clear unstable level will study? Okay? Planetary winds, local winds. Planetary winds means throughout earth they will blow. The westerlies are planetary winds. Throughout earth they will blow. Local winds means few places only. Like Chinook, Foyan, Delhi Loo, West Bengal, Kalbai Shaki, local winds. Even sea breeze, land breeze, also local winds. Monsoons and jet streams. Monsoon means basically you know monsoon. Seasonal reversal of winds, Indian monsoon. Every season, wind will reverse. Jet stream. Jet stream means, I discussed another class, jet stream means basically upper atmospheric winds. So, you know, not road, upper atmospheric winds, jet streams. Also called Ross B. Air mass. Air mass means a large amount of air having same temperature, same pressure. If they form on deserts, they form on the polar ice caps, they form. Entire several kilometers, air has same property. If you go to desert, from here to 10 kilometers, all they are same temperature, same pressure. They will stay there for almost several days. And then they start moving, air mass. We'll discuss them, okay? Frontogenesis. Front means when two different winds will collide, fronts will develop, which will lead to cyclones. Temperate cyclones. Temperate cyclone, tropical cyclone. Precipitation. Types of rainfall. Types of precipitation. Snowfall, sleet, hailstorm, rainfall, types of rainfall. Distribution. Globally, in Europe, what is the rainfall? For example, in Mediterranean area, rainfall happens in winter season. In India, rainfall summer season. Distribution. Okay. In equator, rainfall happens throughout the year. Distribution. Okay. Then, weather and climate. Weather means basically local area for short time. Climate means the average of weather for a long time. For example, climate of Rajasthan is hot climate. But weather of Rajasthan can be? For example, today Rajasthan, rainfall is happening, go and see, rainfall. Today Rajasthan is not dry, Rajasthan is wet. Today is wet, it's weather. But just because today is raining, can you call Rajasthan is a wet state? Because climate is dry. Climate is a long term average. Weather is a low temperature. Actually, Coyapan, not Coppan, it's Coyapan. Coyapan. Thornthwaite and Trivartha, the three climatologists. They divided the world climates. Take the entire world. What are the different climates? Each one of them are different weathers. For example, Coyapan divided based on rainfall, temperature, Thornthwaite based on vegetation, something like that. Okay? They classified the climate of the world. You know, the climate A type. For example, Coyapan says A type climate, B type climate, C type climate, division. That will study. It's very interesting. It's mathematical, very interesting. Okay? Then classification of the hydrocycle. Cycle means is a very small thing. Hydrocycle means the movement of water from atmospheric vapor to rivers and lakes, water to ground water. Plants and animals will take some water, respiration, perspiration, glaciers, ice will be there, movement of water. Okay? Then global climate change. This is environment actually. Climate change. Climate environment. No. Climate change means summers are becoming more hot, more cyclones are coming, winters are becoming very cool. Droughts are increasing, these things. Role response of man in climate change. How is man affecting climate change? By pollution, by deforestation, by polluting, he is changing the global climate. Okay. Applied. Applied means whatever you learn till now, you apply it. For example, you learn about the world climate. Based on the climate, you grow agriculture, do agriculture. In this climate, this agriculture. This climate, this crop, like this. Applied climatology. Urban climate. Urban cities have a different climate. Because cities have more concrete, more pollution. And the climate is very different from villages. Okay? Climatology. Coming to oceanography. Oceanography, just study oceans. Actually, study oceans is a very interesting topic. Because we enjoy it, ocean, Pacific Ocean, Atlantic Ocean, what is there on the ocean, in the ocean, between the ocean. It's very interesting. Okay? As oceanography, water topography means Atlantic Ocean, Indian Ocean, Pacific Ocean, you jump into the oceans, go to the bottom. In the bottom, how is the land? In the bottom, mountains will be there, hills will be there, volcanoes will be there in the bottom. Deep
trenches
will be there. So you study all those things. You can draw very beautiful diagrams also. Okay? Then temperature of the ocean. In ocean, some place high temperature, some place cool, low temperature. Within the ocean water also, surface is hot. As you go deep, it becomes cool. How it becomes cool? It's a very interesting study. Salinity. How different places, for example, in Pacific Ocean, this area, why salinity is more? In this area, why salinity is less? As you go into the ocean, how salt content will change? It's very interesting. Okay? For example, I think study about the halocline, thermocline, study no, pycnocline, density. Okay? Then heat budget, salt budget. In ocean. Ocean heat budget means ocean water is getting heat from sun and underground volcano. How it's getting heat and how it's going out. And salt. How is actually how salt budget is asked in the general studies paper one, two years back, UPSC mains question was what are the various sources for the ocean to get the salt? Ocean gets salt from rivers, from volcanoes, from the marine animals, from the surface runoff. Human beings are using agriculture, industries, water is there now. That will go into the ocean. Okay? So different methods on which ocean gets the salt. Okay? Then, ocean deposit. Ocean deposit, inside the ocean, there are many mineral deposits. You know, actually, in few years, on the land, most of the minerals will go over. Then we have to depend on the ocean only. We are taking ocean only. See, ocean deposits can be biotic deposit, abiotic. Biotic means life deposits. Abiotic means minerals, oil. For example, Mumbai High is there. Mumbai High is petrol from where? Crude oil from where? Ocean or land?
Ocean.
We are taking Mumbai High means the ocean will take the crude oil. Go home, Google search the Mumbai High. On the ocean, large ships, tankers will be there. They will drill into the ocean, take the oil. Then waves. See, the water in the ocean moves in three ways. One is waves. Other is tides, other is ocean currents. Only three methods are there. Three ways, waves, currents, tides. We will study these three movements. Once, for example, on a day I discuss about the ocean currents, waves and tides, night when you sleep, will be moving like this. Because you will have that feeling, moving like this. This ocean water moves in different ways now. You will be involved in that one. Whenever you see any water, you will either see waves, or currents or tides, normal bucket water also. That's what you will get, okay? Marine resources means the fish, cod oil, the seagrass, coral reefs, marine resources. Ocean water the resources. Actually, oceans are very rich in resources. For example, even from agriculture, if you can catch all the fish or different marine animals, eat them, 50% of the food can be from there only, okay? Biotic means life. Mineral resources means, minerals means not only, minerals means, you know, polymetallic nodules will be there. In the ocean, polymetallic nodules under the ocean. You take them, from that you get aluminium, manganese, magnesium, iron, some other things will be there. Very rich resources there. Energy means fossil fuel. Not only fossil fuel, even wave energy, tidal energy, that also you can get energy now. Coral reefs. Coral reefs came in the sense means Genesis paper one. Coral reefs. And you know what? That was a very difficult question. Only geography optional students were able to write, I'm not joking. Really, the question of coral reefs that came in general studies, only geography optional students who studied coral reefs very well, only they can write. Normal NCERTs you can write the answer. You see the question if you want. That question was discussed by me in the YouTube also. YouTube, one of the videos, I discussed that question also. GS for one discussion. Okay. Now coral bleaching. Coral bleaching discussion. No? Coral bleaching means coral will be there, but the algae on the coral reef, algae, it will die. So color will go. It will become pale, coral bleaching. Sea level changes. When glaciers occur, so glaciation, a lot of glaciers formed, all the water becomes ice, water will increase. When deglaciation, when glaciers melts because of global warming, high temperature, ice is melting now. Sea level will
rise.
Okay, like this. Law of sea. Law of sea means actually sea. Sea means this sea. Okay? In sea, there are several international laws. For example, if this is the border of a country. If this is the border of a country, till here, it belongs to this country. In this area, economic zone, only economic zone. Again here, high sea, anybody can use. The law of the sea. If two countries are near to each other, till where you have to divide. Some countries say, for example, Russia is there. Russia's continental shelf, we'll discuss what we're going to talk, is very long. Russia is saying that entire Arctic Sea belongs to us only, because all continents are only. Like that, international law. Okay? Because of INCLOS, INCLOS, international law. That will be asked in the General Studies paper 2. Here also GS paper 2 is there, see? Everywhere GS paper 3. Then, marine pollution, GS paper 3. Pollution, environment. How is ocean polluted? Oil spills, agriculture waste, industrial waste, domestic waste, all these things. Then now, see, these two, if you study very well, these two, you can write very good answers for General Studies paper 3. GS paper is environment. Environment, you can do very, if you use very well, you can write excellent answers for GS 3. And these two are not geography. Environment, trees, plants, animals, general, very easy. Okay? That's why I'm telling you, first three chapters are only. These three are the most important chapters. If you become strong in these three chapters, geography is done. Just done. These two are very easy. How are soils formed? How are soils classified? How they are distributed? Soil profile, zones of soil, soil erosion, how soil is removed, how to conserve the soil. Conserve means soil is being removed by water and air now. How to stop that, save the soil. Distribution of plants in the world, globally, how plants are distributed, how animals are distributed, plants and animals. Deforestation. These are all general studies only. What is there in this? What is geography in this one? Right, we can write. How do you conserve the forest, deforestation, shorts of forest, same thing, agroforestry, shorts of forest, very simple. Wildlife, gene pool study. Gene pool means, see basically, several plants and trees and animals are right now becoming extinct. They're dying. So before their death, what we'll do is we'll try to save their genes. So that tomorrow, if the plant is not there, you can use the seeds to develop the plant again. Gene pools. Okay? For example, I think I discussed about Svalbard, right? Svalbard. Svalbard is a global oil seed bank. Sorry, seed bank. Not oil. Seed bank. Seed bank means Svalbard is a place in the north, near North Pole, Norway. Full of ice. There, they constructed a big seed bank. All the seeds of those plants, which they think are very important, are saved there. It's very cool now. The seed will stay without unspoiled for a long time. It can stay. You keep in the fridge now, if you want to save something. Like that, they keep it in the polar area. Okay, Svalbard. Observe, environmental geography. See, environmental geography, while dealing environmental geography, I will deal mostly current affairs. Mostly current affairs, the laws of environment, policies. We will discuss this topic in a current affairs fashion. Previous four topics will discuss static parts. This part I will deal more dynamically. Okay? Now, environment geography. Principal psychology, I think you finish it in environment class, right? Students who are in environment class, finish it. Ecology principles, human adaptation, how human adapt for ecological systems. Influence of man, how is man affecting the forest, soil, you know, water bodies, environment. Globally, internationally and regionally, within India, how ecology is getting changed because deforestation, alien species, pollution, all these things. How to manage and conserve the forests, water bodies, ecosystem, how to manage. How is environment getting degraded, spoiled? Okay. How do you manage it? What is biodiversity? All the types. The alpha diversity, beta diversity, gamma diversity. Or biodiversity means genetic diversity, genetic species. And then వాట్ ఆర్ ద డైవర్సిటీస్ జెన్ డైవర్సిటీ జెనటిక్ స్పీసీ అండ్ ఎకోసిస్టమ్ డైవర్సిటీ ఓకే దెన్ వాట్ సస్టైనబుల్ డెవలప్మెంట్ సస్టైనబిలిటీ వెరీ ఇంపార్టెంట్ ఫర్ ఎవ్రీవేర్ ఇన్ ఎన్విరాన్మెంట్ ఎకనామిక్ సొసైటీ ఎవ్రీథింగ్ ఎన్విరాన్మెంట్ పాలసీ మీన్స్ గవర్నమెంట్ ఆఫ్ ఇండియా పాలసీస్ ఎన్నో హజార్డ్స్ మీన్స్ ల్యాండ్ స్లైడ్స్ ఫ్లడ్స్ డ్రౌట్స్ ఫారెస్ట్ ఫైర్స్ వాట్ ఎవర్ అండ్ ఎడ్యుకేషన్ ఎడ్యుకేషన్ మీన్స్ హౌ డూ యూ ప్రొవైడ్ ఎడ్యుకేషన్ టు పీపుల్ త్రూ లెజిస్లేషన్ త్రూ సిలబస్ త్రూ మీడియా త్రూ మూవీస్ డ్రామా డిఫరెంట్ వేస్ బై ఇంక్లూడింగ్ దమ్ ఇన్ దర్ సిలబస్ ఎన్విరాన్మెంట్ ఇస్ దేర్ ఆల్ ఇంజనీరింగ్ సిలబస్ డిగ్రీ సిలబస్ ఎన్విరాన్మెంట్ మస్ట్ నో దర్ ఇస్ యాక్చువల్ పార్ట్ ఆఫ్ యువర్ ఎడ్యుకేషన్ లెజిస్లేషన్ మీన్స్ ఆల్ యాక్ట్స్ ఎయిర్ పొల్యూషన్ యాక్ట్ వాటర్ పొల్యూషన్ యాక్ట్ నాయిస్ పొల్యూషన్ అండ్ యూనో ఎన్విరాన్మెంట్ ప్రొటెక్షన్ యాక్ట్ బయోడైవర్సిటీ యాక్ట్ ఫారెస్ట్ పాలసీ ఎవ్రీథింగ్ లెజిస్లేషన్ ఇస్ ఫస్ట్ పార్ట్ ఆఫ్ జాగ్రఫీ ఇన్ పేపర్ 1-2 పార్ట్స్ ఆర్ దేర్ ఫస్ట్ పార్ట్ ఇస్ ఓవర్ ఫస్ట్ పార్ట్ టోల్డ్ ఇన్ ద బుక్స్ లో వన్ మోర్ ఐ టెల్ యూ ఫర్ ఎన్విరాన్మెంట్ జాగ్రఫీ అగైన్ దిస్ సవీంద్ర సింగ్ సవీంద్ర సింగ్ నో హీ రోట్ ద బుక్ ఫర్ ఎంటర్ ఫిజికల్ జాగ్రఫీ బట్ హీ డోంట్ స్టాప్ ఇట్ దేర్ అగైన్ హీ రోట్ ఫర్ జియోమార్ఫాలజీ అని బుక్ ఎన్విరాన్మెంట్ జాగ్రఫీ బుక్ హీ రోట్ హీ కెన్ బై దోస్ బుక్స్ బట్ దోస్ బుక్స్ యూ షుడ్ నాట్ రీడ్ కంప్లీట్లీ ఓన్లీ 4-5 చాప్టర్స్ యూ హావ్ టు రీడ్ ఓకే ఎన్విరాన్మెంట్ బుక్ యా శంకర్స్ అకాడమీ ఎన్వైరన్మెంట్ టెక్స్ట్ బుక్ ఇస్ దేర్ ఎన్వైరన్మెంట్ దట్ ఆల్సో యూ కెన్ రీడ్ ఫర్ దిస్ ఇట్ ఇస్ హెల్ప్ఫుల్ డిఫరెంట్లీ నౌ కమింగ్ టు ది పేపర్ 1 పార్ట్ 2 హ్యూమన్ జియోగ్రఫీ దిస్ ఈస్ ద మోస్ట్ ఇంట్రెస్టింగ్ పార్ట్ ఆఫ్ ఎంటైర్ జియోగ్రఫీ బికాస్ ఇన్ దిస్ పార్ట్ యుల్ స్టడీ హౌ సిటీస్ ఆర్ బిల్డ్ హౌ ఇండస్ట్రీస్ ఆర్ బిల్డ్ వాట్ ఈస్ ది ప్లానింగ్ వాట్ ఈస్ ది ఇంటర్నేషనల్ కంట్రీస్ వాట్ ఈస్ ద ప్లానింగ్ ఆల్ దిస్ విల్ రీడ్ ఓకే ఫర్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్ ది థీరీస్ ఇఫ్ ఎక్స్ప్లెయిన్ ఏరియల్ డిఫరెన్షియేషన్ నాట్ ఇట్స్ టేక్ ఎనఫ్ టైమ్ వాట్ ఏరియల్ డిఫరెన్షియేషన్ రీజన్ దిస్ ఇస్ బికాస్ ఆర్ థీరీస్ డిఫరెంట్ సైంటిస్ట్ టెల్ యూ హౌ రీజన్స్ ఆర్ డెవలప్డ్ హౌ టు ప్లాన్ ద సిటీస్ ఏరియాస్ ఆల్ దిస్ థింగ్స్ ఓకే దెన్ పర్స్పెక్టివ్ హ్యూమన్ జియోగ్రఫీ యాక్చువల్లీ ద బుక్ ఈస్ మస్జిద్ హుసేన్ థీరీస్ అండ్ మోడల్స్ బై మస్జిద్ హుసేన్ వన్ బుక్ ఈస్ దేర్ ద బుక్ ఈస్ ఎనఫ్ ఫర్ దిస్ టాపిక్ మస్జిద్ హుసేన్ యాక్చువల్లీ దెర్ ఆర్ 2 బుక్స్ వన్ ఈస్ హ్యూమన్ జియోగ్రఫీ బై మస్జిద్ హుసేన్ దట్ బుక్ యూ బై డిఫరెంట్ యూ బై హ్యూమన్ జియోగ్రఫీ బై దట్ యూ హ్యావ్ టు బై అగైన్ థీరీస్ అండ్ మోడల్స్ బై మస్జిద్ హుసేన్ దట్ ఆల్సో హ్యావ్ టు బై థీరీస్ మస్జిద్ హుసేన్ దట్ బికాస్ ఇట్స్ వెరీ స్మాల్ బుక్ వెరీ ఫాస్ట్ ఇట్ వెరీ ఇంట్రెస్టింగ్ ఇట్ ఇన్ దట్ బుక్ సమ్ పార్ట్స్ ఆర్ నాట్ దేర్ ఇన్ సిలబస్ డోంట్ ఎంట్రీ నెవర్ ఎంటైర్ బుక్స్ ఎవ్రీ బుక్ ఎంట్రీ వాట్ టు రీడ్ రీడ్ ఓన్లీ ఫ్యూ పార్ట్స్ డోంట్ బై ఎంటైర్ బుక్ ఓకే దెన్ ఎకనామిక్ జియోగ్రఫీ ఎకనామిక్ జనరల్లీ వరల్డ్ అగ్రికల్చర్ ఎనర్జీ వరల్డ్ అగ్రికల్చర్ ఎనర్జీ ఇండస్ట్రీస్ ఫుడ్ జనరల్ ఎకనామిక్ ద స్టూడెంట్ హూ ప్రిపేర్స్ దిస్ టాపిక్ వెరీ వెల్ విల్ రైట్ జిఎస్టీ వెరీ వెల్ జియోగ్రఫీ ఓవర్ ల్యాప్ సేమ్ థింగ్ రిపీట్ ఎకనామిక్ జియోగ్రఫీ ఈజ్ అబౌట్ ఇండస్ట్రీస్ ఇన్ ద వరల్డ్ అగ్రికల్చర్ ఇన్ ద వరల్డ్ ఎనర్జీ ఇన్ ద వరల్డ్ ఫుడ్ ఇన్ ద వరల్డ్ ఇట్ ఈస్ ఎకనామిక్స్ ఆఫ్ ద వరల్డ్ టూరిజం ఆల్సో టూరిజం ట్రేడ్ ఇన్ ద వరల్డ్ ఓకే ఫర్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్ ఇంటర్నేషనల్లీ హౌ డూ యూ మెజర్ డెవలప్మెంట్ డూ యూ మెజర్ బై జీడిపి ఆర్ ఎనీ అదర్ మెజర్స్ ఆర్ దేర్ వాట్ ఆర్ ద ప్రాబ్లమ్స్ ఇన్ ది మెజర్మెంట్ డెవలప్మెంట్ జీడిపి డస్ నాట్ మెజర్ ఎకనామిక్ డెవలప్మెంట్ పర్ఫెక్ట్లీ వాట్ ఆర్ ప్రాబ్లమ్స్ ఓకే వాట్ ఆర్ రిసోర్సెస్ మినరల్ రిసోర్సెస్ ఎంటైర్ వరల్డ్ యూఎస్ఏ వాజ్ బిట్వీన్ రష్యా రిచ్ మినరల్స్ కజకిస్తాన్ రిచ్ మినరల్స్ మినరల్ రిసోర్సెస్ హౌ ద డిస్ట్రిబ్యూటెడ్ ఎనర్జీ క్రైసిస్ ద ప్రాబ్లమ్ ఎనర్జీ వై ద ఎనర్జీ రిసోర్సెస్ ఆర్ లెస్ ఫాసిల్ ఫ్యూయల్స్ ఆర్ డిప్లీటింగ్ వీ హడ్ గో ఫర్ రెన్యూబుల్ ఎనర్జీ రిసోర్సెస్ నాన్ రెన్యూబుల్ ఇస్ ఆల్మోస్ట్ ఓవర్ లిమిట్స్ టు గ్రోత్ ఎనీ కంట్రీ కెన్ గ్రోత్ సమ్ ఎక్స్టెంట్ ఆఫ్ కెనాట్ గ్రో దెన్ లిమిట్స్ టు గ్రోత్ థీరీ బై థీరీ ప్రిస్క్రైబ్ బై సెవెరల్ సైంటిస్ట్ విల్ స్టడీ ఆల్ దోస్ థీరీస్ సమ్ థీరీస్ ఆర్ వెరీ ఫన్నీ సమ్ థీరీస్ అట్ ద టైమ్ ది మేడ్ థీరీ నో యూ రీడ్ ఇస్ వెరీ ఫన్నీ ఫర్ యూ హే వాట్ ఇస్ దిస్ థీరీ ఇస్ పాసిబుల్ థింక్ లైక్ దిస్ దోస్ థీరీస్ ఆర్ రీడ్ సో సమ్ థీరీస్ విల్ లాఫ్ సమ్ థీరీస్ విల్ థింక్ ఓకే దెన్ అగ్రికల్చర్ ఇన్ ద వరల్డ్ వరల్డ్ అగ్రికల్చర్ వెరీ ఇంట్రెస్టింగ్ వరల్డ్ అగ్రికల్చర్ టైప్ ఆఫ్ అగ్రికల్చర్ రీజన్స్ ఇన్ ద వరల్డ్ సమ్ రీజన్స్ విచ్ ఆర్ ఫేమస్ ఫర్ ఫుడ్ గ్రెయిన్స్ సమ్ రీజన్స్ ఫేమస్ ఫర్ కమర్షియల్ క్రాప్స్ సమ్ రీజన్స్ ఫేమస్ ఫర్ క్యాటిల్ రాంచింగ్ ఆస్ట్రేలియా న్యూజిలాండ్ డైరీ అగ్రికల్చర్ ఇన్పుట్స్ నాట్ టు జనరల్ అగ్రికల్చర్ ఇన్పుట్స్ మీన్స్ సీడ్స్ ఫెర్టిలైజర్స్ వాటర్ క్రెడిట్ ల్యాబర్ ఎవ్రీథింగ్ ఇన్పుట్ ఓన్లీ ఇన్పుట్స్ ఎప్పటి ఫుడ్ ప్రాబ్లమ్స్ ఇన్ ద వరల్డ్ nutrition. Nutrition means food problem is no food. Nutrition problem means no nutrition. Very good. See, for example, I am eating only rice. Do I have food problem? No, I have eat rice. No, food is there. Nutrition not there. Because only rice will not give nutrition. Pulses, fruits, vegetables, egg, milk, chicken, mutton, everything added to fish. Okay? So then food security. How to get food security? Famines. Famine, no, not there. Before independence, famine is there. Now India has no famine. Droughts will be there, droughts. Famine means a long drought. People die because no food. Can great calculate a famine when there's no food? People used to run behind rats. Do you know why? To catch and eat them. Okay? That's water is fine, just take it, burn it, eat it. Okay? Then, causes, effects, and remedies. Famine. What are the causes of famine? Both natural causes, man-made causes. What are the effects of famine? Effects you can write about rats, eating rats also. Okay? Then you have remedies. How do you solve the famine problem? By groundwater conservation, by rainwater harvesting, by growing those crops which are suitable for that land, like this. Okay? What are industries? Global industries. Locational pattern. I told this kind of location. Why USA has these industries, here these industries. What are problems in industries? And trade. World trade. Oil from which countries mostly. Aluminum from which country. Iron trade. Okay? So this is GS chapter 3. It's not geography. This is chapter 3 only. They forgot to put in geography. Okay? Then this is all the elements. Population settlements. Population is generally you can answer this just to my newspapers. See, distribution of world population. Japan, more old people. India, more young people. Actually, there are different stages of development. Initial stages, young people will be there. Japan is very advanced. You study about those things. Demography attributes means population has different attributes. Different religions, caste, sex ratio, age. How many in that country, how many employed there? In this country, employment, how much unemployment, religion, caste, all these things. Demographic attributes. Migration. Migration, what are the causes of migration? Cause can be opportunities, cause can be studies, cause can be stress, war, anything. Water crisis, food crisis also. For example, in a country, no water is there. What they will do? Come to the country. Okay? Then concepts of over, under, and out population. Overpopulation means if you take the amount of resources. The population is exactly enough for resources, it's current population, called as out population. If population is very less, resources are more, under population. Resources are less, more population. Like this. Like this, study different theories, okay? Population theories, Malthusian theory, some theories will be there. Marxist theory. One on the population, problems and policies. Different China has one child policy previously. Now India has two child policies, something like that, we'll discuss, okay? Social well-being and quality of life. What is life? What is short-term well-being? Quality means what? Quality means not only good food, good education, good health facility, safety, security, women empowerment, pension, everything is required. Dignity, respect, freedom, everything is required. Okay? Then, population, social capital. Social capital means people sharing knowledge. For example, a village is there. If people do not know what is good food, there is no social capital. Short capital means in the village, doctors should tell and all public, or some NGOs are there, doctors are there, or some volunteers are there, they will go and tell everybody, see, eat this food in the morning, eat this in the evening, so that you can avoid diseases. Or let us say, that is a winter season, or virus is coming, or bird flu is coming, they will tell everybody, you have to save yourself from bird flu by using these methods. So basically, social capital means sharing of knowledge, education, health knowledge, or economic knowledge, sharing of knowledge. Okay? Types and titles of those settlements. I'll discuss this stage. The settlements. Where? Paper 2. What is India? This is the world. In the world, villages, how settlements are there? Clearing settlements, certain settlement language. Then, environmental issues in those settlements. In rural areas, what are the issues of environment? Soil pollution, water, okay? Hierarchy of the settlements. In cities, how are buildings constructed? What is the hierarchy of different cities, etc. Urban morphology. Urban morphology means in the urban area, how are cities built? Actually, population settlements, no. How are population, how different people live in different areas? Different residential area, agricultural area, industrial area, settlement. Morphology means structure of the urban settlements. Okay? Actually, the concepts, very interesting concepts, sir. What is prime density? What is rank size rule? Very interesting concepts where some scientists told cities will be built in this way, their ideas. Okay. All is over now? Over now. Paper 2. Functional classification. Organized rural city. I told you now. Each city based on functional classification cities. Sphere of urban influence. Urban area is there, Vishakhapatnam. No? Vishakhapatnam influence will be there throughout Vishakhapatnam, around area, urban influence. Okay? Then rural urban fringe. Fringe means this is a village, city. In the border, both qualities will mix up. So you go to the border of city and village, they'll have the qualities mixed up, cities and village qualities. Okay? And actually, that is a place where most of the waste is dumped. Cities will generate a lot of waste now. Where they dump? Most are sold. Fringe area is sold. Satellite town means, or main town is there. The main town unable to take all the people. So nearby is other towns. Delhi is there. Delhi. Around Delhi, Ghaziabad, Faridabad. Why is it developed Gurgaon? Why? Because old Delhi unable to take all the people, all industries. So nearby that satellite. Satellite means what? Earth, satellite means around. Okay, like this. Around city, small, small is developed. Satellites. We'll study those things. This is just current, it's very interesting. Problems in rental organization. Urbanization is increasing cities, increasing urban population. Because of that slums are coming, you know, slums, that's a problem. How do you solve the problem? Because urbanization, water pollution, air pollution, slums, all this is coming. How do you solve? Sustainable development is, again. How do you develop sustainably? Sustainably means, whatever development has to continue. It should not stop. Regional planning. This is no good book. For this, I will give my notes. My notes means for everything I have made some notes. Regional planning. Different states in India. What are the totally already? Different countries in the world. Regional planning. That, okay. Now, what is a region? Types of regions. Methodology. There are concepts which you have to learn. Scientists have told. Geographers told certain concepts you have to learn. Actually, these concepts. These concepts. I do not know. Let me see it. See. This is our human geography. This is full of theories and concepts. These short theories and concepts. These three you learn from the multidisciplinary models and theories. One more book is there, that is true. This is general economics. This is general current affairs. Okay? Now, regional planning means what is regional imbalance? Imbalance means some countries developed, underdeveloped. Imbalance. Then development strategies. Regional development strategies is the same. How to develop tribal areas, how to develop the flood area, how to develop drought area, like this. Environmental issues in regional planning. When you plan development now, you have to cut some forest now. Environmental issue. You have to extract more water now, construction, environmental issue, like this. Okay? Planning system development. Same. Last thing is very, very interesting. Just some scientists will be there, they will give some concepts, but these concepts. In the textbook, no, they will give only concepts. But I will explain you examples of India. For example, Perrock's Bodh-Vilay model is there. How is it applied in India? Wang-Thunen model is there, agriculture. How is it applied in India? The theory will be there in the book. There are examples for India. Indian examples, European examples, American examples. The examples I will give you. Okay? Austro's model of stages of growth. Austro's of growth. Okay? I will give you examples of India. So these are different Malthus, Marx. Then you know Crystallus, then Lost, Perrock's, Bodh-Vilay, Wang-Thunen, Weber, Austow. They are the 8 important geographical thinkers. Each of them tell some theory. See, agriculture developed in this way, industry developed in this way, and we will tell example in India. Then you'll understand the theory. You understand? For this again, my notes is important for this one. Textbooks are not enough. This one also my notes is required. No textbook for this one. This one also my notes. But these two my notes are not required. Textbooks are enough for these two. I told you now, 20% of the geography my notes is important. Because textbooks will not cover current issues, relevant issues. I have combined the current affairs with these topics. So while writing the answer, in geography, along with theory, I have to give current examples. Current, you get more marks. Okay? Geography is over. This is about geography. Did you note down the books you have to buy? Those books you have to buy. Huh? అది వార్డల్స్ బై సుభాష్ అండ్ మస్జిద్ హుస్సేన్. లెట్ మీ టెల్ యూ, ఐ షో లిస్ట్ ఆఫ్ బుక్స్, బ్రాడ్ లిస్ట్ ఆఫ్ బుక్స్. These are for physical geography. Physical geography means what? First five lessons are there now. For example, Chandra Singh has all five. Geomorphology, climatology, oceanography, biogeography, environment geography. All five are there, enough. But again, for geomorphology, again, you have to buy this book for few chapters. Climatology, geomorphology, for just few topics, entire book should not read. Environment geography, again, the same lesson. Again, for human coaching video. Actually, these two books, some general studies will also read, not a paper, they will read, okay? Human geography means paper 1, part 2, paper 1, part 2, 12, 5 parts. That is Majid Hussain. Again, Majid other book, general thoughts. This book, Siddhant and Majid Hussain, geography theories, you can buy. But see, in order to read an entire book, I'll tell you, don't buy the book, you read the entire book. I'll tell you, just important topics you need. Mostly depend upon the, as I tell the class, now you are writing running notes. My class, you are writing the notes. If you can write notes complete class, now most will be covered. Okay? Then Indian geography, entire paper to single book. What is that? Single book. Finally, these are common books, which you get NCERTs.